Actually, Donaza really converted me into a politician. Conventionally, I'm no politician. He was a man who has been asking me to be a politician. I resigned from judicial legal service and started my own practice. And that was the time he was really insisting that I should become a politician. I kept on saying no to an abnormal, and I wanted to practice as a lawyer and so on. On one occasion, I was in Kotobaru cross-examining a witness, and I saw Abdullah Ahmad, who is at that time, as you know, secretary, political secretary to him. I got a message, a written message. Tun wants to see you at lunchtime at Istanbul Kripo. And you come alone. Very important. So I nodded to him and I presented myself at Istanbul Kripo. And he said to me, Nkudin, today I'm going to announce you as the Pegawai Penerangan UMNO Negeri Kelantan. Whether you like it or not, I'm going to announce all the same. I said, to minta maaf lah. I had to consult my wife first. Because without wife approval, very difficult to do things nowadays. You must get the blessing of the wife. Without the blessing of the wife, I don't think things can happen in this world. So indeed, I went to see him last time, and he said that whether you like or not, I'm going to announce it. Whether your wife likes it or not, I'm going to announce all the same. And at 5 o'clock, he announced my name as the Pegawai Penerangan UMNO Negeri Kelantan. It was then that everybody welcomed me in Kota Baru, UMNO in particular, members. And I became a politician. That was the starting point. He had been looking after me or observing me for many, many years. When he used to come to London for the discussion or negotiating for the independence of Malaya at that time, I often welcomed him because then I was a member of the Malay Society of Great Britain, who was then, at that time, the chairman was the, or president, was Ali Hassan. Ali Hassan was a judge, or became a judge later on. And it was then, during that time, that I came to know him, and began to appreciate, or looking after him, and he did realize that probably this character being a very good politician. As I said, I became a politician, and he made me first Deputy Minister of Defence. Nasir Hashim was here, who really vouched for me that what I'm saying now is true. And I was made the Deputy Minister. And he said to Gudin, you look after the Ministry of Defence. I'm not going to interfere with what you are doing there, and all at that time. So I became a deputy minister early 70s. And later on, he asked me to become in charge of the special function for foreign affairs. And then in 75, he made me a full foreign minister. In Malaysia, I think either defense and foreign ministry are always the prime minister have been the minister. And it was Tun Ismail who became a foreign minister for a very short spell, for about 9 months. John Ismail is not an easy man to deal with. And he resigned, and he could not get along with Tengku. And Tengku, I said, I wouldn't listen to you. You go back and work as a minister, he told John Ismail. So this is what happened, and I became a minister then. And Tun Razak has been, as you know, a very, very careful man. As you heard this morning, a lot of people have been saying of him, and he's a man who dedicated himself to the country. And he has done very well. He has no sort of grudge against anybody, but he wants to see the country really prosper. And because of him, what he has done, it was indeed, we are grateful to him. And we have recognized the fact that he has done so much for the country. He has developed the country, father of the development, as you know. And during the height of the emergency, he was very much responsible for keeping the things under control, especially communism, insurgency during that time. We had a dark time during that time, and we indeed was very careful in terms of what happened to the country at that time. During the time when we had the riot in May, 13 May, so we had a tough time then to see that how we could sort things out. But he was appointed as Director of Operation. And during the Director of Operation, he has done so much as to control how to deal with emergency at that time. Because it was never thought about that he could tackle. So when he was made as Director of Operation, then he went on to mobilize himself, all his colleagues, his friends, and so on, to get together all the parties in Malaysia into one kind of organization. And because of that, we could see the amalgamation of all the parties in Malaysia into one organization. And you had him getting especially the Sarawak and the others and so on, and also in Malaysia, to get all the parties together into one kind of organization and become Barisan Nasional in sort of a painted and a bigger kind of organization. I would say that when I was made the foreign minister, and we came to know that he was not that well, suffering from leukemia, and not very many people know about it. I was told even to Rahim herself, not aware of what he was suffering. And at that time, it's only three people who knew: Tun Ismail, Dr. Newton, if I'm not mistaken, who was his personal doctor, physician, and him himself, that's all. And on one occasion, I was asked by Tun Hussein to go to London to fetch him back. But before you go, I'm sending you a plane to fetch you tomorrow morning, and come and see me. So Tun Hussein, who was then Deputy Prime Minister, said to me, you go to London to Kudin and bring back Tun. We have arranged on the mass flight that is on Thursday. We've already changed the seating arrangement for the in the plane, and we make a special effort to get the tour to come back. So when I arrived in London, I was taken to see by the High Commissioner, by then the High Commissioner of Malaysia, Dato' Abdullah, took me straight away to see the doctor, and the doctor briefed me with regard to conditions of Tun Razak. And the doctor said to me that the most I can say, it would last for 6 months. And after seeing the doctor, after being briefed by the doctor, the conditions of Tun Razak's illness, I went to see Tun Razak. Kemudian apa buat di sini? So Tun said, I've been asked by the cabinet to take you back to Malaysia, and everything has been prepared, the plane been prepared, and so on Thursday. No lah, Kudin, I want to stay back here after being discharged from the hospital. I want to have a morning walk in the Hyde Park, because then he was staying at the York House in London. And then in the evening, I would like to have another walk. I wouldn't like to go back just yet. Allow me to stay on for a couple of days or a week, more than a week if I can. So that's what happened. I kept on having to tell him that I'm ready to go back. I went to see him twice a day, one in the morning and one in the afternoon, to tell him, to insist and to persuade him. It was so, he did not want to come back because he would like to stay back and to have a walk in Hyde Park. I keep on telling him every day is waiting for him at home. And I said, no, Uncle, please, I want to stay back in London for a couple of days to enjoy my walk in the morning and in the afternoon. So I went to see him twice, and on one Wednesday, I arrived there on Monday, Tuesday, I went to see him always twice a day. And on Wednesday, as I was at the York, I was at the High Commission, I got a phone call, urgent phone call, to say that there's something very important, would like to talk to me. So I got a phone call, and the message from Nordin, who was his ADC then, said to me, to just pass away. And straight away I rang Tun Sen to inform him that what happened to Tun Sen. So we had to get information to all the rulers. When we got the time, the rulers got the message to get to pass or to announce the demise or the death of Tun Razak, Singapore has announced the death of Tun Razak. And we were blamed very much why we did not take the initiative first. Why Singapore take the initiative? Because that was announced by the media at that time. So we have to explain. I had to explain in Parliament why we did not announce straight away. I said it has been custom or our kind of respect for the rulers. We must inform the rulers first. But by the time the rulers got the message, of course, Singapore made an announcement. So that's what happened when Tun Razak. So we arranged everything, and we had everything arranged to bring back the mayat or the deceased to another. And we were so, what we call, happy. As you know, Tun Razak has been very much remembered. He has all the respect of Malaysian, irrespective of Chinese, Indian, whatever the case may be. Because he has been genuine in terms of giving development to Malaysia. There's no doubt, there's nobody else who could be said that the due what happened now that we are enjoying now is, I think a lot can be said that credit should go, kudos should go to Nana. And this is something that we must remember, that Tun Rana is a man who be regarded as father of development and has been responsible very much for what we are now today. And we must maintain this kind of situation, and we must respect a man like Tun Rana to be a man of some